Welcome back in part 5 of the FortiClient deployment and configuration video series. In this episode, I'm going to cover some more advanced topics like certificate-based authentication and the configuration requirements on the enterprise management server, on the Fortigate, and also on the Windows desktop. Let's just start with the client and launch the Manage Computer Certificates option on the Windows desktop and request a new certificate. I'm using a Microsoft Certificate Server, and all that we have to do is just to request a new computer certificate from the Active Directory server. Click on Computer and then Enroll, and now we have a new certificate signed by the Microsoft Certificate Server with the following details. We're going to use this certificate to authenticate the computer at the same time when the client tries to log into the enterprise through SSL VPN. When we look at the Trusted Root Certificate Authority Certificate Store, this is the Windows Certificate Server signing certs. The next step is to export the public certificates of the Microsoft Certificate Server. We're going to use that to import it back to our Fortigate to understand that these are all the valid certificates. This is our certificate authority details, and we can launch the certutil CLI command that will create a file that includes the public certificates. On our Fortigate, I'm using version 7.0.1 and navigate to the certificate store where we can import this exported file. So click on Remote Certificate File and import the root CA. Click on OK. And now we have a new remote CA certificate available. And the CA is true. So the Fortigate can understand that this is a signing CA server certificates. Our next step is to configure LDAP on the Fortigate. Just before we do that, make sure that we can resolve the fully qualified domain name of our Windows server. And it seems to be working just fine. We have the primary DNS configured as our Windows AD DNS server. Go to LDAP server configuration and fill in the required details. I'm using fully qualified domain name. And our distinguished name, this equals FortiLab, comma this equals local. Via regular binds with the administrator accounts. Type the password of the administrator user and click on test connectivity. That came back successful. So now we have a LDAP binds configured to our Windows Active Directory server. Next step is to configure the radius. And for radius configuration, we are using Windows Network Policy Server. Go back to our Windows 2016 server and configure a new radius client on the Network Policy Server. So navigate to Radius Client and Servers and add Fortigate. Right click on the Radius Client and select New. I call it Fortigate. So Fortigate is going to communicate through the management IP, and I'm using that fully qualified domain name that points to that IP address. Give it a shared secret for radius authentication between the Fortigate and the NPS. And the next step is to create a new network policy for what the Fortigate can send to our NPS server with what the details. calling it Fortigate Network Policy. Click on Next. And let's just add a new condition. And I want to look up an SSL VPN group. And I want to look up user association to a specific group. That is the SSL VPN one. Next, enable MSCHEP V2 for encrypted authentication. The rest can be left on the default and click on Next. And create a new vendor-specific VSA. This is going to be a custom. Click on Add again. The vendor code for Fortinet is 12356. And configure a conforming attribute. The attribute number is 1, that is the string value, and call it VPN underscore group. Just close, and then click on Next. Verify the details, and then finish the configuration. And that's it. Now we have a configured network policy server to communicate with a Fortigate for user authentication via RADIUS. Back to the Fortigate and configure the RADIUS server with those details. I call it Windows RADIUS. I'm using MSCHEP V2. I'm pointing it to the Windows 2016 fully qualified domain name. And type the same shared secrets. That's the connectivity. And let's have a look if we can use it for authenticating the user. Yes, it returned successfully. So the RADIUS configuration is correct. Close the configuration, and our next step is to configure a user peer option. We're going to use this user peer option to bind the certificate validation to the user accounts. I'm calling it domain cert check. I'm specifying which signing certificate authority should be used to validate the client certificate, which is RCA cert 1. What is the LDAP server details to validate the user? And I'm using the principal name. Next, let's just configure the user group. I'm calling it SSLVPN_users. And I set the membership for our previously configured domain cert check and also the Windows RADIUS option. Config match. Edit 0 is a useful option. Edit 0 specifies the next available option on the Fortigate, and it can be used anywhere in firewall policies, address objects, or in the specific case under the user group configuration. We can go back to the web UI and check the details that we just configured in the CLI. It could also be done by the web UI. The next step is to configure our SSL VPN settings. Let's go there. Specify on which interface SSL VPN is listening on, which is our external internet facing interface. I'm changing the listening port to 10443 because I don't want it to conflict with our management HTTPS access to the Fortigate. I want to request client certificate validation and enable the user group that we just created, the SSL VPN underscore users. And they should have full access. That means split VPN tunnel, but also browser-based or web-based VPN access through the Fortigate firewall. And for everyone else, we only enable web access. There's a warning that we still need to configure firewall policy, so let's just do that. Give it a name. The incoming interface will be our virtual SSL VPN tunnel interface. Our outgoing interface is the interface on the LAN subnet. Source is any. And specifying the user group. So those users can connect from any source on the internet. The destination is a new address object group that will use our LAN network subnet. It's only a slash 24, and I'm going to bind that subnet to the port 2 interface. For service, I'm just select all. I don't enable any security profiles, but net is enabled on the port 2 interface IP address. And I'm just logging all sessions, not only security events. So click on OK to save the new firewall policy. And that's it. Now we have SSL VPN fully configured on the Fortigate firewall. We can review the firewall policy. We have two of them, one to enable LAN access to the internet, and the second one is to enable inbound SSL VPN tunnel access to the corporate LAN network. When the remote client logs into the desktop and initiates the tunnel, now we're going to have a new option for certificate-based authentication. Go to remote access. The client is currently off the fabric, so we can use the remote access option. And next to username and password, we can also select specific client certificates. And if all the details are correct, the client will be authorized to access the network. Now we have the VPN running. Finally, let's do some SSL VPN troubleshooting to understand the different outputs on the Fortigate firewall. First thing is just to have a look at the CS certificate in the CLI. If we just run show, we won't be able to see too many details, but we can edit the same configuration and just run the get command. That will display all the details of the specific certificates. Let's just get out of this configuration. And see our Fortigate firewall certificates. Fortigate can be configured to do mutual authentication as well. It authenticates both the client, and client can also authenticate the server. And that's why we are having a signed Fortigate firewall certificate uploaded to the firewall. Under the SSL VPN configuration, we can see the first line is to request the client certificates from the endpoints. Enable debug level logging for the SSL VPN application on the Fortigates. And we should be able to see outputs when the client initiates the tunnel. First with the incorrect password. So among all these outputs, what we can see is the SSL authentication failed, the client certificate was requested, and the user sent the correct username, but the SSL VPN login sent a permission denied message back. So it looks like the certificate was correct, the username was correct, but the password was wrong. And the user was found in the SSL VPN cert user group. The session was terminated and the firewall destroyed the circuit connection. Next, let's do the same thing but select the incorrect certificates. Here we can see that the Fortigate was unable to verify the client certificates. It was unable to find the local issuer that signed that specific certificate that the client sent with the SSL VPN connection requests. And again, this session was destroyed. And finally, let's start the VPN tunnel with the correct authentication details. Here we can see again ErrandCon logged in, the data sent to our Windows server, the certificate was requested from the client, and the matching firewall policy was found. And the client received the IP address. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.